Hello beauties, welcome to a new video. Today I am going to show my entire eyeshadow palette collection. Here is just some of it. It's the things I have on the front in this acrylic holder. And I have two drawers too. So we start with this. I have the Tribe palette. This is one of my favorites from Yuga's place. Amazing. And this is the douche palette. I think it's pronounced that. I am in love with these two shades here. And I like this palette more than the most other people. This is also one of my top favorite from UBS. I like the color story, I like the shades, and I'm pretty neutral for being me, but I don't know, it's something. I really like this one. And we have the Zulu from UBS. Love this also. The Love This is going to be a really regular word for me, or this palette, it was the first Yuga's Place palette I ever bought. And this green is one of the best green I have. But I haven't used it so much I want. And I don't know why. I don't reach for it so much, but the color story is really my thing. And this is one of the newest from Blush Tribe. No! What do I say? UBS, I have. It's the Warrior Tree palette. A really nice color story. This metallic blue is amazing. What have happened? It's black on every palette. This is Sahara 2 by UBS. This is also one really, really great palette. A bit neutral, yeah. But I use the word all the time. This burgundy red is amazing. And this Jaffer, yeah. Really good. Really, really good. I like this. Neutral with a pop. This is Yuvia's Place Festival palette. I like this more than I did it in the beginning. I have always been like green, purple and blues. That's my thing. And this is not my thing. Reds and yellow and pink. I don't know, I have always been like, I don't like pink all my childhood, and I don't like pink, it should be green. But now I have done some looks with this color story and I like this more and more. It was not that I didn't understand it, or yeah, it wasn't my color story before. This is A Freak by UBS, and it's so nice. What should I say? I feel that this is going to be a really long video if I am going to talk about every palette. I talk about some palette more, and the most palette I try to not talk about. This is Sahara 1 by UBS. This golden shade. It's really amazing. I really like this too. This acrylic holder is from Coco Panda, a Swedish store. It's four sections here. And you can see you can have really many palettes in them. This is my only Natasha Denona eyeshadow palette. It's the Mini Gold, I think. Mini Gold palette. I think it's so cute, the perfect size, and I love the colors. These three colors is amazing. And the quality was like... No. Out of this world. I have never tried something like this before. The shimmer was really amazing. I really want to try more Natasha Denona palette. But she haven't released any palette that's really screaming for me. I want some more of the minis. But I think the big ones are so expensive. But I have my eyes open for her. This is the only melt palette I have. It's Smoke Session. And I am so happy I own this from Melt. I think this is the nicest or best that fit me best from Melt. I am really happy I got my hands on this one. Real nice. The shimmer are out of this world too. We have two from Kaleidos. This is Futurism Cyber Bronze and Astro Pink. This was the first two I bought from them. The packaging is amazing. And the color story. These two shades. Okay, this also. These three. I have no words. The shimmer is so good. The quality of all Kaleidos palettes are really good. This red shimmer. Perfect red thing. Really good. Recommend Kaleidos for everyone to try. It's one of my new favorite brand. They have really stole my heart. Here we have really much blush tribe things, and they are no longer available, and the brand not exist anymore. This is Neon Dreams Revamp palette. It's really nice, but I unfortunately got the one with the bad patch. Some palette were really good and other were really crappy. And this was the palette I was one of the most excited about, because I haven't so many neon-y things and I really love neon. And it's something I miss in my collection. So do you have some tips on neon palette that's really good, or neon pigments that's working amazing? I especially want green and yellow and orange and pink, but green and yellow. So you can't use it, like the shades disappear and so, but I'm going to try some more techniques with it. But it's no longer available, the brand, so I have it like for memory and collector purpose. I almost have all UVS. No Blush Tribe is palette. This is Hasina 1. This was gifted to me from my fiancé. He only bought two palettes. To me, and Hasina 1 is one of them, and I love this palette. This shade is so unique. It's really good, nice color story and nice formula. Blush Tribe was my favorite brand. Now we have, this is from Makeup Addiction, Sinful Eyes, their latest palette, but it's not so... It's like over one year ago, so it's not so new, but this is so nice. I love the color story, especially these two shades are talking to me, but the other shades too. I really love the color story. I need to pick this up more because their formula are so good. I really recommend Makeup Addiction. Really like them. And I have the other palette from them too, but they are in the drawers. This is the only BH Cosmetics palette I have. It's their Weekend Festival. I am so happy I bought this one. And I really love their formula in this. And I am so sad that I didn't get a hold of the new ice cream release they have. I really wanted the pistachio, the green one, and the blue, and the purple one. Because I know the formula are really good, and everyone raved about them and say they are so good. But I don't know. I try to not buy them. Because I know I already have the colors. It's a money question. I can't get a hold of them if I want, but I really don't need more palette. You're going to see that in this video. And I have the most shade that exists because I have so many palettes. But when it's greens, blues or purple, they suck me in always. So I try to dupe it. I think I succeeded with that, to dupe the palette. This is Blush Tribe Sonia Sarin. The background do like this is not it don't show the real colors in the pants because of the background, but I think this is really my kind of neutral. It's a little pop of color, and it's not the boring neutral only browns. It's some color in it. This is over my expectation how good it was when I tried it. This is the Blush Tribe Blossom eyeshadow palette. This I didn't get a hold of. I was too late. But Paulina Asbjørn sold her one to me. So this is Paulina Asbjørn's old palette. It's so good. But I bought it most for the collection value. Because I want to have them all. And I don't miss anyone, I think. Yeah, one. Blush Tribe palette. Really nice. This is the Munasa, I think. Munasa. Yeah. Really. This is also the thing with the background. You really don't see the colors so good because of the background, but I was so unsure of this palette before I bought it. And then I bought it and I was so surprised. This is really for me. It don't show that I have used it. But I did a palette bingo collab with this. I have it up here on my channel somewhere. And I was so surprised by this color story and the formula and the quality. They were so much better than I expected, over my expectation. I love when that happened. This is the Malika from Blush Tribe. Really nice berry mauve tone in this. I really like this row. This was the Fall Fusion from Blush Tribe. I really love this. This is the perfect fall palette. This is Paulina Asbjørn. She did chose this shadow. And where is she? This is Angelica's shadow. Angelica Nyqvist. That have, yeah, new name, but yeah. They did chose out this color. They are also Swedish YouTuber. I love this. I love this. Really, really much. This shimmer is so amazing. And the color story is so good. I have used it really much. But this was also a palette I was unsure of. But I am so happy I bought it. I bought this when I was on a vacation in Greece. Had it under watch and ordered it the second it came out. This is Linda Hallberg. Eller, it's called Linda Hallberg. It's how you pronounce it in Swedish. The Spectral Palette. This is my favorite palette from Linda Hallberg. And it's so nice packaging. And the front is really nice. And I love the color story. I really like this one. I have done some looks with this. And I am impressed. And it's not so many people that like this so much. But this is my favorite from Linda Hallberg. So, this is Lila 1. And this is old shades from Mixed Blush Drive palette. And she did a new rainbow palette. But this is, if you have all the other palette like I do, you have this. But it's a collector thing. And I think it's really nice. It's all matte to have them here. These two shades. So good. So nice. Now we have some... or all my... so dusty. Certified palette. I have 4. This is the Destiny palette. I love this color story. More like... fall and grungy thing. This is also a perfect fall palette because you have a pop here of more color than just a typical fall thing. I really recommend Certified too. It's Certified and Blush Tribe, they are sisters and have 2 different companies. But Blush Tribe is no longer existing and it's Salma start a new brand, My Alley Beauty. I think it pronounced that. But the Certified is really good. Really good quality. Love the size of this and the packaging. This is one of my favorite palettes of all time. It's the Affinity 2 palette. And you will see why. It's perfect. Almost perfect. I miss some more purple. But we have 1 here, purple. And yeah. They are so good. I have used... this is one of my most used palette. I really love it. Love it. I had this palette when me and my fiancé did celebrate 10 years together. Was it last year? Yeah, it was last year. And he loved the looks. This is the Affinity 1. Here you also have a good fall palette. But I think the... Destiny is better for fall. This is also a really good palette. And this was my first Certified, the Tropical Wonders palette. This was also the first palette I ever bought with matte. An all matte palette. It was my first all matte palette. I was that person that didn't get the thing with matte. I use always an only shimmer. And then I did look on much YouTube and I am so late to the game, but then I did understand what the matte did for a look and I just, oh my god, I don't have a single matte shade in my entire collection. I need to buy something. So I bought this. And this complements everything really good. A stunning palette. And quality wise, the Certified is so good. This is Smash It. The only glitter palette I have. But I only need to open this and look at this. Then I get so happy. I get so happy. It just sparkles everywhere. I love this. This I have used so much, especially for Christmas. I used to do like a glitter eyeliner with that. so good. I think this is so good to have like a complement to other palette if you want to have glitter. But nowadays they have some press glitter in the palettes and I really love that too. I love to have glitter on a look. It do so much for the look and it pops. Here is the newest drawer, but you have already seen this in the first video. But yeah, I'm going to... Okay, this is not new, but this is here because I want to use this color story more. This is Hasina 2, one of my all-time favorite palettes. And this is the second one, or it was the first one my fiancé bought for me. So this is really dear to me and special. And the color story, it's like me. This is Anna palette. This is me. Love it, and the quality is so good. Love. This is my favorite palette of all time. I haven't found a better palette yet. It's the Paulina palette from Blush Tribe. It's a collab with Paulina Asbjung and Blush Tribe. The color story is amazing. And this shade, all talk about this shade, friends. It's so unique. This is so amazing. And I love the color story. I love everything about this palette. When I don't know what to do, I always reach for this palette. And I do looks I always love. Amazing. It would be amazing if Paulina could do another collab with some brand. And do her own palette again. Because this palette, it was a success. Really. Yeah. Here you have the Inglot Powerpuff Girls palette. Only 3 small shades. Small, good. I haven't tried so much. This is the Coral Cutie palette from Nabla. Really nice. Have used. And really like it. Pastels from Beauty Base, own brand. Don't so impressed. Yet, at least. 3 more Kaleidos. Futurism Turquoise, VR Neon, and Science Fiction Green. Oh my god. I have put my sleeves on the name here, so I know what I'm talking about. I think that's good. I miss that they don't have the name in the palette. I really love that. I don't like... I get a bit upset when it don't have any names. Love this. Love. Amazing color story. This is one of my favorite. The color story is so unique. It's a turquoise. And the VR Neon. No longer available, unfortunately. I am so happy I bought this before it ran out. And 3 from Colourpop, yeah, you know. Really nice quality, nice formula. Oh my god, I am so hungry. I have like record videos in like 2 or 3 hours now. It's a record day today, so I do many videos on one day, so I can record and like have a good schedule, so I am in front of my schedule. So if I like record 5 videos or do 5 videos now, and then I have videos for like 5 weeks. So I have many weeks I can do whatever I want. This is the Escape Pod from Kaleidos. Amazing. Nice color story. Really good quality. This is from My Alley Beauty. It's the Rex Bella palette. Limited edition. Really nice. you have already seen this, so I am going to go this through this fast. Ayubia from My Ally. My came broken, the mirror, so but the stick here hold it together, so really nice. And Yaya from My Ally. Oh my god. I love this palette. I am in love. Big time in love with this palette. And it's so neutral. But this is also a palette that's my kind of neutral. Amazing. Amazing. And the last from My Ally, Jasmine palette. This is so freaking good, and this is also a perfect fall theme, or yeah, color story. Really nice. And the last here is Wahala from Yubia's Place. Good, amazing, love the glitters, love everything. I have one more here, acrylic thing, and I am going to try to show you, but my ring light is in this one. This is my Norvina Anastasia Beverly Hills Norvina collection. This is number 3, the mini one. Really nice. Impressed by the formula. Love the glitter. This is also ABH Norvina collection number 2. Love this one, and the color story, amazing. The mini Normina collection number 1, also loving this one, really good. This is my Linda Hallberg Enchanted Mysteries palette. This green is freaking amazing. My Creepy Cute from Strobe Cosmetics, and they have changed name now to something. Amazing. The best pastel palette I ever have. Unfortunately, the black has broke. And I really tried to repress it, but it didn't go to repress it. And I have some more blush tribe. I think I have 2 left. This is the Pastel Tribe. Really nice. I have the Urban Decay Moondust palette. Love it. Love it. As you can see, I have used it really much. This is Anastasia Beverly Hills Norvina collection. Norvina Pro. Yeah. Things. Everything know about this. This is volume 1. Hard to open. It's really big. Like my head. I love them. I have all, you will see. I really love them. Here we have number 2. Oh, so nice. Color story. I was so happy they did something with color for once. This is my favorite of all. This is number 3. This was not released in Sweden. Only number 1 and 2 came to Sweden. I love this color story. This is the one I really love the most. Amazing. Amazing. This is number 4, the latest. They released in May this year, I think. It's so good. I love this also, but I really love it. This is the last blush tribe palette I think I have. This is Lila 2. And look at this color story. It's screaming my name. I really love this. Amazing. Amazing. Anastasia Beverly Hills Subculture palette here. I really love the colors and color story. This is Amerisi. And I really love this. It's so freaking good. And the packaging is so nice. I love it. Now we are hopping in to my drawer here, and Corona is here and she won't to be cozy. This is my Urban Decay Electric Palette. Really love this palette. Juvia's Place, oh my god. Oh, Masquerade, Mini Masquerade. I am happy it's mini, because the big is really big. And we have here Nubian 2 from Juvia's. I really like this. It's like a more dark, grungy color story. I like it, but it's not so many matte, and all matte are like browns. That's not so good. I prefer some colorful matte too. This is my Urban Decay Vice palette. Look like this. And this is my biggest palette, the Magic by Juvia's. Oh my god. It's really big. I love all the Juvia's palette I have. I love the formula of Juvia's. This is the Queen palette. Fumi, they did a collab. This is supposed to be like a blush eyeshadow palette thing. And I really like it. The color story really is really nice. And the formula, really good. Here is Juvia's Nubian 3 Coral palette. I love this. But I haven't had time to use it so much because I did an Juvia's order when I was really sick. So I haven't had time to play with them. But I really appreciate the gray here. Because I have start liking grays. Oh my god, this is not going so good. This is the Nomad from Juvia's. I really like this too. This is also I like neutral in my type. And I have the Warrior 2 by Juvia's. Oh, the black is broken. I have tried to repress it, but it's too close to the magnet, so it's something that's going not so good. The only thing I really miss from Juvia's is the Warrior 1. This is Nubian 1 by Juvia's, the most neutral one. I did bought a bundle the first time I ordered, so I did get like 6 palettes from Juvia's place. But it was so affordable. Here you see the most of my Anastasia palette. I have some on the display. This is Carly Bible. I didn't plan to buy this, but I am really impressed. All Anastasia palette I have bought is much more nicer in the reality than in the product picture. This is Sultry, the most neutral I think, but I liked its the cold tones here, and the shimmers are so nice. Here we have Alyssa Edwards collab with Anastasia. Can I say some more than love? This is my kind of colors. And I have the Jackie Aina palette. This is amazing. I really love them. I am so impressed. Here is Rivera. Also like this one. Or I love all my Anastasia palette. And this is Norvina. Really good day-to-day palette if you want. Really nice. Here we have some Colourpop. Or here I have my Sigma palette. Cream de Contour. I think it was from 2017. Their pastel palette. Really like it. This is Sweet Talk from Colourpop. I think this is one my favorite palette from Colourpop. I am so amazed with this. And that this glitter is amazing. It's perfect glitter for this palette. I love this. And I have the Good Sports from Colourpop. This is also so nice. Missing the glitter though. And Bye Bye Birdie from Colourpop. Also really nice. And I have only one Too Faced palette, and it is Sweet Peach. Like, but not the most likable in my collection. Here comes the other Makeup Addiction palette. This is Smoke Out. As their formula on their shimmers and mattes are so good. Really like them, or love them. Love, love, love. This is Vintage. This shade is amazing. Really nice. And I have Flaming Love. These two, three, are so good. It's so good that you can take them out too, so you can arrange them that you want. This is Meadow. Amazing. Can't say anymore, but just try them. They are so good. Here I have one small Sugar Pill palette, and a really old one. This is something. Addicted to Pretty. Nice. I really wanted the small, new, cute thing palette from them. But I wasn't sure. What do you say? Chromatic, monochromatic palette? I don't know. It's like one color theme palette. This is Meant to Be. So nice. I really love these palettes, all of them. And the quality is so nice. Just my luck. This shade is amazing. I have almost all. This is Strawberry Shake. I don't have the peach one because I have Sweet Talk, and I think you can dupe the sweet peach, so you don't need it. Oh La La palette. My fiance loved this palette. I don't know what got into him, but he really started liking me in pink looks, and I just, okay, not there I want to go, but yeah. Oh, Lilac You a Lot, really nice. But I start appreciating pinks. It's My Pleasure. I really want my palettes to look like Paulina's collection. You know, they are dirty and they are panned. I love her collection because you can really see that they are used, and you can't see that in my collection, and I am so sad. This honey. I really want to have a collection like Paulina Asbjørn. You really see that she loves the things she have because she has so much dip or dent and pan in her collection. This is Orange You're Glad. This is so nice. I want to do a look with this soon. I want to do a orange look for a long time. Main Squeeze. Oh my god. My battery all come to die soon. Blue Moon. This is so good. Oh, amazing. The best, one of the nicest blue palette I have. And the last is Blowing Smoked. Real nice. This is so good. Yeah, finally, my last drawer. And this is the most unused drawer. New things. Not new things, sorry. It's supposed to be new things. Later, but not yet. And all my Kat Von D palettes, and some Revolution and some single shadow in palettes I have picked out, and some palettes I don't like. We can start here. This palette, this is from Carity, Rose All Day. I don't know what I'm going to say. I hate this palette. This is the worst palette I ever tried. The only shade in this palette that works is that shade. Really shock pink. All the other shades have hard pan. When I did get it, when it was new. It's not pigment. It's no pigment at all. It's only that shade that works. The other shade is shit. This is really hate palette. It's here and get ashamed. Hidden away. I have it in my collection only because I want... if I want to compare and so. As a reference. This is my Kat Von D Metal Crush, I think. Yeah. No, Metal Matte palette. Sorry. I really love this palette. I am so happy I got this palette. I love it. But it's a bit big. Really big. And here we have my Kat Von D Fetish palette. The magnet is so... I really love this palette too. And love the color, sorry. The grungy feeling. And so, I really like more grungy, dark. Like Halloween, vampire. Yeah, dark things. But it's so freaking big. And the shape, it's really strange. And really hard to store. I need to have it like this, and it takes so much space. That's the thing I don't like with it. Here I have my Shade and Light Eye. Really good base palette. My Interstellar. This is a bit Kat Von D collection here, so. And my Crystallize. I do miss the other one with the orange butterfly on, but it's so neutral. This is the anniversary palette. Yeah, it's the 10 anniversary palette, I think. 10 anniversary. Yeah, I did say it wrong before when I... talk about this is some video. It was the highlighted video. Yeah. This is so good. Or good. It's really nice. Here we have the Vegan Love palette. Oh. Or vegan it's called. But it's all shimmery. It's a palette to complement other palettes. Yeah, this is better. Hello Dark. Kat Von D, the Kat Von D half in the Too Faced collab they did. This red is so good. I really like this. But I don't have the Too Faced half of the heart. I have the Lolita. This is so good. Really love this palette. I don't have the Lolita Pro something too. I want to have it. But it's only in collector purpose. And I need to get rid of that. Thing I have it in my head that I need to collect. some brand I collect, and it is or was Kat Von D and Blush Tribe. Yeah, it's hard to not do. This is Divine eyeshadow palette. The first time I ordered from Kat Von D own side. I love this. I really love this palette. That was all my Kat Von D palette. Here we have some Makeup Revolution. Okay, it's I Heart Revolution, but I say Makeup Revolution because it's them and their 1000 brand. Tasty Avocado palette. Oh, really nice color story. And I have this one. It's their Chilled in their Flawless collection. Yeah, you know this. This is the best quality or formula they have on their eyeshadow, I think. The Revolution. I love this palette. Really love this. But I wish this glitter was in also a shade and extra glitter. But this is their best formula. It's in that kind of packaging, the Flawless collection. This is Forever Flawless Eyes. Oh my god, this had... Yeah, Forever Flawless... Chilled with cannabis. So yeah. Flawless Eyes. I really love this palette. The color story is so nice. I don't have so many blue palettes, and that disturbs me a bit. Really small, limited edition makeup store palette. Here we have Jungle Rock from Wet n Wild. The shimmer are really nice, but the matte are really uneven in the quality. Some is really good, some is really shit. Here is my own C palette. It's Makeup Store and this is Inglot. And I have one more C palette with Makeup Store. Here I have my small NYX. Oh, only NYX palette I have. Ultimate Edit in Brights. This is really nice. NYX is a really expensive brand, I think, for being affordable. In US, I think it's really affordable, but in Sweden, it's so expensive, I think. This is Smashbox. And it's a bold, glittery eye palette. Yeah, okay, I lied before. I have two. This is number two. I always forgot this little palette. That I have two glitter palettes. A small single shadow palette. This is also Makeup Store. This is my only Essence palette. I really love this palette. It's really neutral, but it's so good quality. I am so impressed by Essence. And this is Nabla, Sugar Pill, Makeup Geek, and this is Lethal Cosmetics, I think it's called. Oh my god, this is Lethal Cosmetics. Really nice things. And this is Colourpop, Makeup Geek. And Nabla, I think. And this palette is from Makeup Store, the Moonshadow palette. This I got from a friend, from Julia, when it was some birthday gift some years ago, and I love this palette. It's so nice. Hello, hello. I, of course, did forgot this, too, from Kat Von D. It's the Saint and Sinner palette. Because this I have in my perfume shell. And this is so nice. But it's so nice packaging. Aesthetically really nice. And my favorite Kate Von D palette. Mi Vida Loca. I am so happy I have this. This is my holy grail. This is amazing. I love this palette. I always forgot these two. Because they are in other places. I am hopeless. Deluxe. That was all. Yeah. A video in like hours and hours, I think. I really hope you like the video. If you want, I can count them and put it here somewhere. I think it's like 120 something. Yeah, I know, it's so much. I really need to declutter, but I have... It's my babies. I have so hard to get rid of palettes. It's really hard. Hope we see you in my next video and have a good time. Bye!